Yo, it's your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different, and today I want to talk to you guys about something that's kind of a studio basics, but it's going to be something that's going to help out newer producers or artists or whatever, and kind of help you out with some issues that you're probably having within your studio, and probably people who don't understand this. So today we're going to be talking about latency and your buffer size, and how do they kind of intertwine with each other with CPU usage also. So first let's talk about, what exactly is latency? Well, latency is basically the time it takes for a sound to be picked up by your microphone, to go into your interface through your DAW and whatever you're processing, and back out your interface through your headphones or your monitors. That's what latency is, which pretty much is also called the round trip, meaning a round trip, meaning from one end to the other, back and forth. That's what latency is. Now, what is their buffer size? Now, your buffer size is basically how many, like, samples you have, and or samples or milliseconds or something like that. I don't really know it on a full technical term, but how much time you have, or time like your computer or your interface or your audio card or whatever you're using has time to process that sound to spit it back. Now, you know, that means like a lower buffer size, meaning it will have a short amount of time to process all that and send it back to you, which as a higher buffer size, meaning it'll have a longer time to process that stuff and send it back to you. So what that essentially means is a lower buffer size will give you less latency, meaning you'll be able to hear yourself sooner than like almost real time, if it makes sense. Now with a bigger buffer size, you will have a delay or a bigger latency. So you kind of see where I'm going right here. You got, you know, smaller buffer size, smaller latency, meaning you'll be able to hear yourself really quick. Larger buffer size, meaning more latency, meaning you'll hear yourself with a delay to it. Makes sense. So smaller, shorter, bigger, longer. You get it? Simple, right? Now, how does that kind of affect with CPU usage? Well, see, I've noticed a lot of producers or engineers, when I go to their house or show me their screen, share their screens on Skype or whatever, I notice that when they're mixing and they're like, why is my computer glitching out and stuttering and all that? It's because they have a lot of plugins, for one. They have a lot of plugins, SoftSense, VST, sound, sample packs, whatever, reverbs, compressors, EQs, all that on their DAW. Then they have a small buffer size. Now, what that essentially means is your computer is trying to compensate for it. It's trying to process all that's going on, all your sounds, your reverbs, your effects. It's trying to process all that super, super fast and spit it back out. It's not having enough time, so you're getting glitches, hiccups, stutters, jitters. You're stopping and starting the sound, cutting in and out, because it has no time to process all that. And then I see people, when they're trying to record, they're like, wow, when I record, I have this super big delay. And I'm like, they say something like 3 seconds later, they hear what they're hearing. And they don't really truly understand that and get why it is doing that. So basically what that really means is like when you're recording, you want to have a small buffer size, because you're only going, you want to be able to hear yourself with the absolute most accuracy you possibly can. If you have a larger, if you're mixing, you want a larger buffer size because you got a lot of plugins, a lot of VSTs, stuff like that going on. You want to be able to, you know, have all that processing going on and your computer be able to not struggle. Because like I said, if your computer is trying to process a whole bunch going on, but you have a small buffer size, it's not going to be able to process all that. Just the same way as you have a big buffer size and you're trying to record and try to record accurately, it's going to mess you up. So basically what I'm trying to tell you, and what I'm trying to, you know, throw at this way is, you know, if you want to record spot on and, you know, like record with auto-tune or a little bit of reverb, have a small buffer size. The smallest you should go is however small your DAW interface allows you, but the highest you should go is about 128. That's like 4 milliseconds. And that's usually what a brain can kind of process that and kind of, you know, work around that. But if you're mixing, like you're mixing, you're trying to put out these effects like that, you want the largest buffer size possible. That way you can put a lot of strain on your computer. Because like I said, unless you have a supercomputer or a super fast interface like a PCIe one or a Thunderbolt, you really don't want to try to do that, because it's going to, like I said, slow you down. So that can help you out with CPU usage and kind of help out with some of that latency issues and glitches and pops and clicks that probably people are having. So remember, at the end of the day, remember, if you're recording, small buffer size, you know, small buffer size, not many plugins. So probably 1 or 2 plugins on your channel to like reverb or auto-tune or something like that. But if you're mixing, put the biggest buffer size you possibly can. That way, you know, you can process all them sounds going on. So I hope this tutorial helped you guys. And it's very simple, but some newcomers, they might not understand that, might not know that. So I hope this helped you guys out and gets a great sound. So y'all know who it is, your boy Slim, aka Mr. Different, not motivated by money. Like, comment, subscribe, and views. And I'll see you guys next time. Have a good one.